Yo, what's going on, everyone? It's Brian here from Drink a Beer and Play a Game, and today I'm going solo. As I've stated before, the rest of this month I'm going to be focusing on first-person horror games, and what better than, to some degree, the game that started it all off? I'm of course talking about Outlast. Developed and published by Red Barrels, this game first came out on PC in September of 2013. It would eventually get a release on PS4 and Xbox One in 2014, and just for reference, I use the Xbox One version when playing this game. To sum up the synopsis for this game, you're essentially an investigative reporter, and you're trying to figure out what's going on at this remote psychiatric asylum that's located somewhere in the woods in a small county in Colorado. Needless to say, once you get there, a whole bunch of crazy shit starts happening, and you're fighting for your survival. Graphically, this game is really impressive. As I mentioned, it first came out on the PC in 2013, and to see a first-person game like this, it just blew your mind. Now granted, before this game you had things like Amnesia or System Shock, but in my opinion, none of them looked as good as Outlast. Every little detail of this asylum is pretty well done, but I will say, there's playing on the Xbox One, there's something that just feels slightly dated about this game. While the graphics may not be perfect, there's nothing that really hinders your ability to feel immersed in this world. However, the biggest issue I do have, and I know I'm dipping into gameplay here, is the whole gimmick of this game is that you're recording your experiences through this camcorder. I'd say 80% of the time you need to turn on night vision because everything is pitch black. So you constantly just have to see this green grainy filter, which is a really nice kind of cinematic approach to it, but it's just not as appealing. The last thing I will touch on is the fact that, good God, did they make this game gruesome. Between some of the bodies left around and just the inmates that you're gonna run into, and just how they look, it's demented. And I'm not gonna lie, when I was playing through this, it was creepy as hell. And of course, there's those two random naked giant dudes that are chasing you, and you don't know what the hell they're gonna do to you, so they really decide to go in detail on some of those things. All in all, I decide to give this game an 8. It is clearly above average, but as I said, since you are forced to go through that camcorder view for the majority of the game, you get a little bit more graininess, and especially when you have night filter on, it can be a little annoying. So as far as beers, I'm gonna add 2 for those two naked dudes that are trying to kill you, because that is beyond disturbing. The sound in this game is everything you would want from a horror game. It's a lot of atmospheric and ambient noises, and you're not really filled with sound effects because it's obviously trying to mimic a real life situation. However, the soundtrack, while it might not be exactly memorable, it fits the mood really well. What I do like is the fact that they throw in the typical horror troped, you know, music cues. When action is going, you get something really high paced, and when nothing's going on, you don't really have a whole lot. Problem is, about 80% of this game, you are being chased, so the music can be a bit jarring, and I know that's what they're trying to do to disorient you. I just thought, okay, sometimes they could have toned it down. All in all, just like the graphics, I gave this an 8. It's definitely above average, but since there isn't a memorable soundtrack, I couldn't go to that 9 or 10 level. And as far as beer, I'm gonna add 1 for every time you're being chased, your heart is gonna be beating a little bit faster thanks to this soundtrack. The control is quite simple for this game. I've already alluded to the story and what your goal is, but this was one of the first games, in my opinion, where you truly feel useless against your attackers. There's no attack buttons. All you can do is film and hide from these guys. So your action buttons are pretty limited. Between the camera controls themselves, which just involve raising the camera, turning on the night vision, zooming in and out, and then your movements. It's very, very basic, so there's not a whole lot to remember, so you catch on very quickly. What I will say is there are times when you need to run and jump, so your jumps need to be pretty accurate, but this game is actually fairly forgiving with that. And let's not forget, you will be doing a lot of vaulting, climbing through windows, climbing into lockers. I never actually felt like there was much of a delay. I will say there were some times when I was in a panic and I accidentally reloaded my camera. For me, the control wasn't exactly perfect, but it was really damn close. As you can see, sticking with the graphics and sound scores, I gave this an 8 again. It took me no time to focus on the controls, and quite honestly, in a game like this, when you're so focused on trying to stay alive, you can't have too much of a convoluted control scheme. As far as beer, I'm not going to add any. I'm absolutely fine with this control. The gameplay. As I mentioned already at the beginning, the story goes that you're going through this psychiatric asylum, and you're being chased by random inmates. You come to find out that there's this kind of satanic cult going on, and the leader of this cult is leading you through this asylum that's more like a maze to try and, I don't know, keep testing you. But what I will say is, the story is the most intriguing part about this game, and you really do feel at some points like you're just trying to figure out what happened here. You can collect notes and certain documents that give you more clues as to what went on, but as I've mentioned before, you're really just trying to survive the night. And I gotta say, there's so much of this game spent just standing in a locker and waiting for one of the enemies to walk by. At first, it's such a cool mechanic and it really does get your heart beating. Not that it ever stops, but I feel like after a couple hours, you kind of get bored of that. Now, they do have some nice sections where you're being chased, which really ups the ante because so much of this game is really slow. Like, you're really taking your time, and then once those chases happen and you're not hiding, man, it will get your heart going. The only other real unfortunate thing for this game, for me personally, was that it was really short. I mean, I beat this game in about a little over 5 hours, and that was screwing around, taking my time, and I was drunk. I've seen some people, if you know what you're doing, you can beat this game in as short as 2 hours. And that's unfortunate, because that's not a whole lot of time playing this game. So really, my only complaints is that the gameplay itself can become a little bit monotonous, and it almost feels like more of a chore than fun when you're hiding, and it is a short game. With all that being said, I gave it a 7. Still above average, and it was still a great horror experience for me, but it's one that I may way down the line decide to go back to or play with the new Outlast game, but I don't know how many times I'm going to return to this title. As far as beer, I'm just going to add 1, because although it was an interesting concept to have no ability to fight back, I would have liked something like a push or a kick that would have made the game a little bit more interesting when you're being attacked. The originality. Well, I'm going to sound a little bit like a broken record, but not having played many games before this where you are so helpless against your attackers, and you're really trying to take on that role, the investigator, I felt like this was a brand new experience for me. Sure, there were other games in the past, like Fatal Frame, that you were technically investigating or trying to find out information of what happened at a place, but this one, I was really interested in trying to figure out what went on here and why did this crazy shit happen. Plus, the hiding mechanic, it did feel brand new. Obviously, there are a handful of games now that use that mechanic, but man oh man, just learning to hold your breath and not get caught by these guys, it was a skill in itself. So I ended up giving this an 8. While this is only 4 years old, this game still manages to feel like a new experience if you haven't played it yet. And as far as beer, I'm not going to add any. Good for this game for giving you a new original story. The replayability is an interesting one because while the overall game itself, the experience won't change, how you deal with people chasing you or how you decide to hide or how you navigate through the asylum is really up to you. It's completely open-ended. Sure, there are some predetermined chases as I've mentioned before, but I mean, you can kind of go at your own pace. Now, the only reasons you'd want to come back to this game is to make sure you find all the documents, maybe check your time, but the ending is going to be the same every time. With that being said, I only gave it a 6. There's still enough for you to come back and experience through the game, but it's not enough to keep bringing you back because you will kind of be reliving the same moments over and over. Overall, if you're a horror game fan, there's no way you should avoid this. This was a game I'm sad that I didn't get a chance to play earlier, but once it was released on Xbox, I couldn't help myself. I'm so glad I finally got to play it, and like I said, getting that new experience, it would change the gaming for me in general, because I was used to horror games like Resident Evil, even Silent Hill, or any other game you could name that you think of horror. But in all those games, you can still at least fight back. When I figured out that you were so screwed in this game, my mentality had to completely change. And I can't help but think games like this are what help define certain genres. So that's why this had to be number one in this month of first person horrors, because I think this helped reinvent this genre. So I gave it an 8. And when I combined all of my scores together, it rounds out to a 7.7. Considering all the praise I put on this game, it was really the gameplay and the lack of variety in it that brought the score down, but still, that's an above average score. And I know I say this many videos, Jim and I don't exactly give 10s that often. When it comes to beer pairing, I'm gonna have to go with the Rogue Ale's Dead Guy Ale. This is a Maibock or a Hell's Bock, and it comes in at 6.8%. So it's actually pretty strong, and after a few of these, you're gonna be feeling pretty tipsy. However, this beer goes down really smooth. And for some of those more calm parts of this game, or the times when you're just hiding in a locker, this beer will really come in handy. So grab a couple and enjoy. But remember to drink your beers and play your games responsibly. As always, guys, thanks for checking out this video. And if you enjoyed it, make sure you give us a thumbs up, leave some comments, or better yet, why not subscribe? Till next time, guys. Cheers.